So you get your camera and you go out to shoot some night creamy bokeh footage, but then you get out at home and you discover that your footage is just screwed up by flickering lights. So how to get rid of flickering lights in camera, we'll be discussing it right now. What's up YouTube, welcome back to Newpix, where we learn how to be better photographers by sharing experiences and mistakes. And before jumping into the content, I just wanna say that I plan to push out more kind of vlogish and personal videos on the channel, because I think that I tend to not post content because I want them to be perfect, I want them to be super cool, but that prevents me to actually giving you content, and I think that's much more important, giving you my experience so that you can pick up from my mistakes. Now regard the topic of the video, which is flickering and how to get the camera setting right to avoid it, let's start by saying what actually flickering is. Now this is a pretty interesting thing, because you have to know that the electricity that goes up to the lamps, for example, and our power sockets, is not a continuous source of electricity, and in fact it's called AC, which means it's alternate current. What that means is that our lamps, they receive not a continuous source of power, so they go on and off all the time. The thing is that we don't see it, because this happens at such a high speed that our eye cannot keep up with it. However, our cameras, they can do it, if they have a shutter speed which is high enough. And that especially is visible when you shoot footage. For example, you have to know that the alternate state of the current is not the same between different countries. Actually, in Europe, the rate of the alternation of the current is 50 Hertz, while in US, and I don't know if that's the same in the rest of the world, it's 60 Hertz. This number is extremely important, because that will determine how you will set up your camera to avoid it. So if you're in Europe, what it means is that being the current of the street lamps, for example, 50 Hertz, you cannot shoot at a higher frame rate than 50 FPS, so you cannot have that really ultra slow motion at night, because that will enhance the flickering of the lights. So just set 50 FPS on your camera, and your shutter speed has to be slower than 1/50th of a second, and you got to experiment a little bit, because maybe you can get it away with multiples of 50, like 1/100th of a second, but you have always to check it. Well, for example, if you're in US, you can shoot at 60 FPS, your shutter speed can be 1/60th of a second or 1/120th of a second, but at 1/120th of a second you might have some flickering. So the takeaway message is that according where you are, be aware of the alternation of the current, which is the rate of it. In Europe is 50, in US is 60, and then set your camera accordingly. And here you can see a sample of a video footage where I shot with complete random settings, and I didn't take care of setting the camera according to the frame rate, and you can see that the lights are flickering heavily, and that totally screwed up all my footage. While here I correctly set up my camera, shooting at 50 FPS to have a little bit of slow motion, my shutter speed was at 1/50th of a second, and as you can see, I had no issues with flickering. So take home message, be aware of the geographical area where you are, set your camera accordingly, and you should be ready to go. Now I want to also give a little bit of shout-out to my project, which is called Reflexinky, and that's when I discovered actually this problem, because I went out with the camera and I wanted to shoot some cool night bokeh with wet streets footage to promote my Instagram channel. And if you would like to see what I'm doing over there, just head up to Reflexinky, I'll put a link into the description section. But here is actually the footage that I should have trashed, because it's so flickering. But I don't know, for some kind of reason I really like it, so I just want to share with you. Tell me what you think about it into the comment section. Tell me also if you have any other tricks to avoid the flickering lights in your footage. And I'll see you next time. Remember to shoot, learn and improve. Subscribe to the channel if you like what I'm doing. And until next time, stick around and take care.